Greetings and blessings. Here we are again. Wow, this is number 25. It would be 26, but last Friday we were out at Hawaii Spiritual Center playing and gonging out there, so we didn't record it. Although I did try. It didn't work so well. Working on it. We're going to play and loosen things up for about an hour. And then we're gonna meet you back here. Find yourself a comfortable position. Headphones are okay. Good speakers are better. Do what you will. Good speakers actually help move the energy in your body, because it is the sound waves interacting with the water and the molecules in your body that help. But do what you can. If it's coming into your ears, that'll work. Find yourself a comfortable position where you can be still for an hour-ish and keep breathing, especially if things get riled up in you emotionally or physically. Feel free to move if something gets tense, or stretch if you need to, whatever keeps you comfortable. And we'll see you in an hour. Ka'imi and I are gonna breathe our three breaths together and ground in. And then we're just going to get started. Kitty is blocking our light, so I had to turn the overhead on a little bit brighter, but she's warm, and that's what's important. See you in an hour.
Thank you. Thank you.
as we bring this meditation to a close. The invitation is to find your toes. And your fingers and your nose. You might wish to take a few deeper breaths. Bring some more oxygen in. I know when I lay down for a gong session, my breath tends to get more shallow. So the invitation is to have a few deep, full, slow, and comfortable breaths as you feel the bits of your body waking up. Before we started today, I overheard one of our housemates who was listening to a YouTube or something. He was talking about quantum physics. And the point being made was that the act of observing changes the outcome. I'm not saying that quite right, but the point is that the action of my observing something influences it. So one of the reasons why I talk a lot about my lady here reminding me to be in joy and to make joy the focus, gratitude the focus. Because when my consciousness is centered on gratitude, the world is a place worthy of gratitude. And that wasn't easy for me to get my head around early on. Because how could I be so powerful as to influence the world around me just by where my attention and focus is? And yet, from the early days of research in light and finding out that light has properties of both particles and waves, it's pretty clear that the act of being measured and observed changes things. And I don't know why, but somewhere in the middle of the gong, I had a memory of the movie Roots and how it came out as a long miniseries when I was a kid. Actually quite surprised my mom allowed us to watch it. We were that young and impressionable, and it made quite an impression. And just as importantly, later I learned, was the impression that all of the controversy that came up around the author and whether or not it was his ancestors and all the little quibbling that came about to shift people's focus away from the fact that the slave trade was horrendous, is horrendous, and people suffered. People suffered at the hands of my ancestors. And I was a little confused that that came up. Except now there's the Dr. Seuss controversy. Because he was a product of his times, and some of his cartoons and creations were pretty racist. And a lot of his stuff is really juicy and opens creative pieces in my heart and my brain. So what, should we throw everything that he ever did out because he was a product of his times? So that was in my head, and I'm thinking, why in the world would I want to talk about that? Is it just going to put people's attention on that? And then so as I was sitting here, I asked for guidance in the words. And that's when the quantum thing came rolling back into my head. Energy flows where attention goes, is what I've heard that fits in that quantum model really well. And so I get to choose where my attention goes. And I'm going to put it on warm kitties and lovely partners and joyful sounds and energy moving. And the evolution of all of mankind that I make up, that unless you've got your head in the sand, you've got to be aware of, because it's happening in so many arenas. And in some, it looks really murky and ugly. And others, it's just amazing the number of people who are waking up. And this helps me wake up with smiles and grins and a light heart, and knowing that there's a lot of ugliness in the world, just I don't want my attention there. I want my attention on you and how brilliant you are and how magnificent you are and how magnificent the technology is that allows this to be shared with you. God knows how long from now. So the invitation is to stay awake. As Rumi says, don't go back to sleep. Use your breath. Use your yoga. Use meditation, use love, use your pets, use your food, use your focus to be an evolutionary part of our world and our universe. Because we are anyway, and we may as well put our attention on the good stuff. Thank you so much for your time and attention and listening to me ramble. Thank you so much for your joyful playing and partnership. It's Friday. It's February 5th.
No, March.
Yes. Well, at least I know that it's 2021 and not 2012, like I said last week. Let's do the time warp again. We'll be back on Sunday, 7 o'clock. It's community, Vibe Tribe Community Sound Circle. Hopefully, we'll have community with us. We'll see. Not too worried. Amy and I'll be here because it's what we do. You'll be here because it's what you do. Love, love, love. Put your attention where you want your world to be. And we'll see you again.
Aloha.